Because if they did, they can get lost. I have never been so insulted in all my life. Really, laughed at. Balderdash. Are you quite certain you're not a spy? Those wretches will do anything to destroy me. My theories are correct, and I can prove it.
What are you doing?
I am the leading amateur paleontologist in the nation, and not one university will hire me because, unlike them, I actually have ideas.
You're a what?
I study dinosaurs. You know, big lizards.
Are they real?
Of course they're real, you nincompoop. And everywhere.
Everywhere?
This state was once a vast, shallow sea that had the most incredible animal that could walk, swim, and fly. Quite unique. I call it Totalosaurus. Just for now. I'm trying to gather all the evidence. Miss Deborah McGinnis?
Arthur.
Good to meet you. Could you give me a hand here, please?
Of course.
Yeah. Listen. If you find any of these bones around the country, send them to my homestead at Furwood Rise in Cumberland Forest. Or mail me the locations. I'll reward you handsomely for your efforts.
Sure. Why not?
And we'll be proving a lot of stuck-up buffoons very, very wrong. Which, trust me, is the very best thing about science. Good day to you, sir!
Here. morning.
To carve a country from man's desire and not some old world juju.
How you doing, my dear friend? So, Mr. Morgan, whatever did happen with that Mary Gillis?
It all came to nothing, Miss Grimshaw.
That's for the best.
Sure, of course.
I never did like her very much.
Sounds like a father to me.
Not bad.
So much.
Not just with the reason, but...
Morning, Arthur.
With the reason.
Hey, if you could give me some leather working tools, I could make some rugs and blankets and the like out of these hides you're bringing in.
You'll be fine.
Okay.
I reckon I'm gonna think about it.
Get old John to see it a little sense, we might be able to make a proper family.
Good morning.
We both know that ain't gonna happen.
You never know.
Well, that's something neither of us know.
Not yet.
Really funny.
Yeah. Let's go, boy.
Hey, Arthur. Good to see you.
Why? You want rescuing again, dear?
No. I got a plan to make it up to you.
A plan like the Blackwater Ferry job, or like you going off scouting and ending up in jail?
Dutch said you was a big shadow cast by a tiny tree.
I don't even know what that means.
I thought you was a tough boy. Not one of those gentlemen trying to protect his riding clothes.
Well, I just know whenever things get real, you turn yellow and lose your head.
Yellow?
Sure seems that way.
So I guess you won't be riding with me to rob the banking coach comes about this time into Strawberry. I heard one of the O'Driscoll boys yapping about it while I was inside.
You and me? Do a robbery?
That's what I said, didn't I?
After you.
There's a spot up this way with a good view of the trail.
Come on now, boy. What are you doing anyway, camping out here like some crazy hermit?
Can't exactly stay in town now, can I? Like I told you, I ain't going back to Dutch without a peace offering.
So what's the deal with this coach?
What do you mean? Comes through about this time every day, like I said, the end.
I mean, how many men? Guns? Riders?
Nothing serious. It'll be fine.
I heard the bank's been hiring every trigger man they can get of late. The meaner, the better.
You worry too much.
Forgive me if I ain't wholly faithful in something an old Driscoll told you when you was half drunk in a jail cell.
He kept yapping about it, saying how they've been hitting it on the regular. That's a good lead in my book.
Damn, old Driscolls are everywhere now.
Bastards got a hold of most of Big Valley. Heard they took over some big ranch north of here.
How the hell you and Lenny end up down here, anyway?
Oh, you know how it is? A few loose ends. Drink here, drink there.
What loose ends?
Nothing that needs to concern you. I always pay my share.
It concerns me when you put us in danger and we don't realize till it's too late. Like that move you pulled in Strawberry, making me kill half the town just for your precious guns.
Precious they are. You need to roll a little looser, Morgan.
Looser? I seen you come full undone more than once now, and you only been running with us a few months.
Are we gonna rob this coach or bicker about it? What's done is done.
Guess we're robbing it.
Then let's do it. Ha! Hold up on this ridge.
They should be here in a little bit. Hold tight.
Which way will they be coming in?
Should be from over there. We need to hit them fast before they get into town.
Just don't lose your head this time.
Of course, tough guy. They should be here any minute. Look, there they are. Right on time. Get covered up. Come on! Ride! Hiyah!
Come on!
Here, we go!
to keep your face covered now. It's just you and me, sweetheart. How long does it take? Next time, I'll leave you in the dust.
I'm hoping there won't be a next time.
You don't mean... Yeah!
Job I do with you ends in a pile of dead bodies.
Since when did you have a problem killing O'Driscoll's?
You've got a point.
Let's strip this coach then. It clearly ain't going nowhere now. You know, we should really pick up a lock breaker one of these days. Save ourselves some bullets.
Yeah, because saving bullets is such a concern of yours.
Let's take what we can and get the hell out of here. That lock should shoot off easy enough. I'll give you the honors. On account of, well, this little mess. You shooting it or not? Come on, I'm happy to do it myself. I'm done wasting my breath on you. That should do it.
Come on, let's see if all this was worth
it. All I see is you, me,
A river full of dead O'Driscolls and a lockbox. I'd say we're golden here, Morgan. Look at that. What's the cut here?
It's good. Just make sure the gang gets its piece.
Yeah, yeah. Like I said, big shadow, tiny tree.
And like I said, that still don't mean nothing. Get out of here. You'll see Dutch. Make sure you ain't followed.
I know, boss. I know. It's been fun!